Okay, so today it's kind of a weird thought, because my last video I was really like, well, it's gonna be, a lot of fighting at homes and in their houses with people, all of a sudden they're together packed in tight. I'm going, oh my gosh, I have to stay here and with you and okay, so all of that's gonna go on. But then on the other hand, there are gonna be those households where it's like all lovey-dovey all the time, and they're going to have, that all of a sudden. I think somebody did a study like that, that's if you take people away from work, we end up with such a baby boom that we can't handle it. But so what's going to happen from this? They're going to be called the COVID kids, and think about it. So before you start planning your little child at this moment in time, that kid, if you really wanted to make a baby right now, it's gonna pa be packed in a classroom with all the other COVID kids. And are there enough teachers for the COVIDs? And you have to think about that. So they're gonna be like born sometime around December, early January-ish, probably around Christmas. So they're they always do, they're those babies. They get that advantage of the not advantage, because everybody's like, oh no, not them also, because it's Christmas. So yes, you're gonna have those kids all being packed into school rooms and wondering how they're gonna get a good education, because we all know the larger the classroom, the lower the education for those kids. So now I'm already foreseeing the COVID kids as being more raised into, after 19, 20 years of life, raised into more manual labor jobs, being more less articulate, less intellectual. Just because of classroom size from the public school system that they're going to receive, because there will be that boost of little children. So anyway, something to consider, to don't, if you were planning on having a kid, maybe just wait a while, maybe wait a year, I don't know. Try to give them a chance to it's going to be the COVID rush. And I don't, or if you're gonna have to have a kid right now, maybe like realize, are you gonna homeschool it? How are you gonna give it a superior advantage over the horde, we'll call them, the horde of children that will be all of a sudden be born, because there are no condoms, there's no women running around looking for what do you call those things, contraceptives. It's gonna just gonna be, oh my gosh. It's afternoon, it's morning, it's evening, and we have nothing to do, and there's nobody here, and we live in an apartment, and oh my gosh. And then the woman, a month from now, is pregnant. And so, and then it all goes on, it all goes on, it goes on. And then December, there'll be lots of babies, and January. And as long as this COVID thing is going on, there will be lots of babies. So it'll be a boom. Anyway, so yeah, I don't know. That was kind of a silly video for me to say right now, but it is something to consider. I never had children, so I don't know that anything about, so much of the workings of them, but I do know classroom sizes, and I know that is something to really we're going to have an issue with, as well as I don't know. I want to also go back to this testing that they keep pushing and pushing on people. I wouldn't do the testing unless, I was really feeling sick, if I really had those symptoms. Because you can get the te you can get sick, very shortly thereafter. So it's almost like you would take the test for naught, for no reason, and then walk out over there, and then you get it again, get actually sick. So you would have to just keep testing and testing the rest of your life. So, as long as this thing is going on, so it only really makes sense to do the testing, if you were a really feeling ill. And I know that's probably wrong of me to say, but it also seems like an opportunist moment for the testing companies to have as many tests as possible, you know. And it is a vulgar test. One man mentioned it's a Q-tip that they stick up your nose, and they went so far that he feels violated. He thinks they've gone into his brain. So yeah, it's a very, very terrible test in certain cases. So I don't know. I know you can have it and you don't have any symptoms, and yet you can still be a spreader of it, a transmitter of it. It was scary, you know, and a couple days ago I saw two women from the Netherlands. I knew because they were talking Dutch, and they had the masks on, and I was like, whoa, that's really weird. What are they doing here? You know, whoa. It was like, you know, you go into like, and they were at the store, the groceries, you know, but they were wearing their masks, which is good for them, of course, but nobody else was. There are very few women wearing masks, more women than men. I haven't seen any masks on the men, only women. And oddly, I will say Caucasian women. I have not seen Mexican-American women wearing masks. I haven't seen, I did see one African-American wearing a mask. And it actually wasn't a mask, it was a bandana. It was very cute, a very nice little bandana. Strung through her hair like that, it was darling. And so there are other ways, because we don't have masks here, you know, they're not for sale, and if they were online, they're very pricey. So you got to think of those types of things, like bandana. That's a really good idea. Just a half scarf, you split it and you put like a ribbon and just run it through the back of your hair. That's nice, and it gets it tight, and then if you could run it across the bottom some way as well. But I've seen people with ferocious looking ones, you know, like with the filter in the front. I'm like, wow, that's pretty neat, you know, where'd you get that? You know, so it was a face mask, and it actually has like its own little probably a HEPA filter type, but that anyway, so it's interesting to me who there's not very many cases here in my particular town thus far, but they are creeping up, you know, and they are all different ages, oddly. You know, we have teenagers here getting it. So it's a very different tell, you know, it's a different happening from the tell, because we've been told it's always the old people, always the old people, and then now we're seeing even the youngies, the young teenagers or college students getting it, and 40-year-olds, so that's a little shocking. But yeah, really, this is more about the baby boom itself, that is gonna create. That's all. And do I have anything else? Oh, remember, it's spring. First time of spring is happening right around, all the way around. So if you even have squash, go ahead and plant those seeds. Yeah, look for some videos out there on how to do that, and get them in the ground. They're really nice to have around. And it's like, yay, you know, it makes you feel so happy to have grown some squash. Anyway, I'm off to the races. Okay.